floats on my knee. Lies for the streets, but it's so much tea. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. I don't wanna miss out on the holiday, but I can't stop staring at your face. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. With you, shout it to you, with you, shout it to you.
Special project for you and Lena, and then you guys do that here. I said you're not staying.
I'm about to leave to go help.
Okay, go. Jake.
I'm sorry that I have a couple more minutes and would like to spend it with people I enjoy.
Screws having the time of my life. Nika and Sophia, what are they doing? Because they're not doing a lot. That's all I have to say. I'm really carrying this. I just wanted you to know that because Without me, there would not be organization. Thank you. They're putting the Phillips head with the star bits. Gets on my last name.
I didn't even put the Phillips with the star bit. That was actually Sophia. And it was like one. It was like one of them. And then she picked it out and then she moved it. And then it was really no trouble. And that's all I have to say. I think she's being a little bit dramatic. In my opinion, she doesn't come to tech for 2 years and then she comes one day and then it's suddenly, I'm doing all the work. I'm doing all the work. That's all I want to say about that.
Because they said it was going to be a fun rehearsal. It was not a fun rehearsal because I had to take out the trash.
You do get that.
Why do I have to carry the full one all the way there?
I'll carry the full one all the way there.
You can put this on the shelf.
Why do people come here and they all act like they love theater and then all they do is complain? They say, I'm not going to miss it. I really don't want to be here. I hate all you guys.
I do everything around here and it's so frustrating because I can't clean the shop and sort the screws and delegate and play music and go on trash runs all at the same time. And when I ask someone to pay, can you please pick up this piece of wood and put it in the wood rack, I expect them to do it. Does he do it? No.
I mean, we like clean the shop and everything and then she just feels the need to get mad all the time. It's kind of really upsetting that I'm like TD now and she still treats me like I'm not, but whatever.
Of drama happening, and I'm kind of in between all of it because I don't have a stance. I'm also not in the same tech class as everyone, so I feel like I just am out of the loop in many aspects, but I don't know, it's just there's a lot of tension, I would say.
What do I think of Zane and Alicia fighting? Oh, that's old news, that happens every single day. Honestly, while they duke it out and establish who's top dog for the rehearsal, it's a pretty good chance for me to run things how I want while they're busy. We get a lot done. For the past couple weeks, what I've started doing is I'll just take a freshman aside and I'll give them secret first aid duty for the day. And their job is to either follow around Alicia or Zayn, whoever they want, and just whenever the brawling starts, they make sure that no one needs to go to the hospital, give them band-aids, and everyone goes on their way, and that keeps everyone on task.
If I had been there, I think I could have talked them out of it. You know, they're just so tight. They're just best buds, and they get along so well, and they work so well together. I just... It's really a shock.
Do I regret it? No. He deserved it.
I just thought this whole, like, TD relationship was gonna go a lot smoother. Because, like, I'm nice. She's typically mean. So I thought this would be, like, a nice duality. But... I think she just needs to see me as somebody that can, like, handle the department on my, like, I'm also a TD, so, like, I can do it. She just needs to, like, trust in me. So, once she gets over that, we'll be good. Good job, Tex. I'll see you next time. Bye. Please, John, they didn't do any work today.
Then we cleaned up the whole shop on our own.
On our own. Terrible. Bye, guys. Great job.
It's not bad to be jealous. It's just a feeling, just an emotion. Jealous people don't kill or anything. Oh, wait, they do. But that doesn't apply to me because, you know, it's all just ridiculous. They don't know what they're talking about.
They're just telling you the truth.
And you. I'm getting tired of you. What happened? You look completely different. You don't even look like a monster anymore. You've changed. And you're talking in sentences.
I did, didn't I? What a glorious thing. Why didn't I try this sooner? This is truly glorious.
And you're clean. And you're wearing nice clothes. But you're talking in...
complete sentences. Yes, we established that.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
I don't like this plot twist at all.
I think I'm here to stay, Jane. I like this place. And you're such a gracious host, if I may say so. The more you deny me, the stronger I get.
I am not in denial.
Well, that's the spirit.
You can't get stronger. I don't want a monster inside of me. You can't stay.
And yet, here I am. So what are we going to do today, Jane? School? We can walk the halls and have substandard cafeteria food while we hear the taunts aimed at the less fortunate. I adore the classics. No? What about the mall? You don't like them all, do you, Jane? All those girls with their better looks and their better bodies.
Stop it.
They've all got money to burn, too. They don't have to look at the price tags like you do.
Stop it.
They wear clothes that you can never fit into. They own cars, and you don't. They buy CDs by the dozen. Haven't you always wanted to be a musician, Jane? That'll never happen for someone like you. I adore hating them so much.
Shut up, shut up, shut up.
I'm hungry, Jane. Let's go get something to eat.
I don't want to. I'm not hungry.
This isn't your show anymore, sister. I'm just getting started. The play is mine.
You can't do that.
Change of set, please. You got the lead in the school play? How on earth did that happen? I have more talent in a baby finger than you have in your entire body. You won that writing competition? I should have won. You've got half as much talent as me. You made the basketball team? Of all the luck. How in the world did that happen? You get everything you ask for, don't you? You never have to lift a finger, huh? Where'd everyone go? You sure know how to clear a room, Jane.
Why are you being so mean?
I'm just acting on your instincts, Jane.
No, they're not my instincts. I would never say those things.
Oh, but you thank them all the time. And you say them behind people's backs. Do you think that just because you don't say something straight in front of someone's face makes it all right?
No, you've got it all wrong.
Well, if you'll excuse me, I have business to take care of.
As you can see, I'm in a bit of a bind. I didn't expect this turn of events.
Who are you talking to?
The audience.
Oh, I see. Are you jealous of any of them?
Only that they're out there and I'm up here.
Well then, I'll just continue with what I was doing. The monster crosses in front of the previous main character, Jane, upstaging her handsomely. The monster turns its face and smiles and says in a dulcet tone, "Come on, Jane, we're going to a party." We're at a party now.
What kind of party is this?
It's a jealousy monster's ball. I've been dying to attend one, but I've never been fully developed.
Great.
I owe it all to you. Thanks a bunch, kid.
So, all of these people have monsters inside of them.
This is just the tip of the iceberg. Monsters are everywhere. Just because you don't see them doesn't mean they aren't there. Hiding in your ears, sitting on your shoulder, sucking up your thoughts. And once you let a monster out, it's practically impossible to get rid of it.
Impossible?
That's right.
Impossible.
I have no time for small talk, Jane. Come on, mingle, mingle.
I don't want to mingle with monsters. They seem awful.
Who said you had a choice? No.
Hey, my name is Tyler, and I made the Tin Man costume for a tech production, and it's from The Wizard of Oz. And I chose the Tin Man because it's a really good Halloween costume. Everyone knows the Tin Man. Everyone knows The Wizard of Oz. It's a classic. So there's no way you could mess it up if you were to see it. And also, it's just a very notable character in the movie.
Hi, I'm Lucy, and here's a quick intro to my project. So I filmed my improv troupe's performances over 5 weeks, and I covered this in the beginning of the video a little bit, but my troupe has been together for a really long time, and we've been performing together for forever, and improv is like one of my passions. So I checked with my troupe, and over 5 weeks, I, you know, filmed our performances, and I edited my favorite scenes and my favorite sketches together. I'd like to give a special shout out to the members of my troupe. Phoebe, Calvin, Lainey, Mayla, Garrett, and then our coach Lily. Big shout out to them. All right, see you in the video.
Brody, if you put the robe from the hotel in your suitcase before anybody notices it's gone, you get to keep it for free.
For free?
If for nobody free.
Is it like a game?
It's like a game. You're trying to like take as many things from the hotel room as possible before they charge your bill.
Ooh, I really like the sofa.
Can you fit it in your suitcase?
Probably.
Try it. Go. All right. I've got is a really pretty lamp. I'm going to see if I could just...
It fit.
It does. Well, you got to fit the rest of the stuff in here. All right, let's see. This is a really nice generic painting, you know, like the ones that are in all the hotel rooms. It's got a horse.
Yeah, I love horses.
I like horses too. Let's put it in the bag.
Yeah. Cut to them trying to check out of the hotel.
Oh, getting that stuff down the stairs was so hard.
Yeah, too bad the elevator was out of order.
I hope you guys enjoyed your stay at the Two Mountains. Wow, you guys are really heavy packers.
Yes.
We were planning on staying for longer than we did.
Oh, is that a couch?
I brought it with me. I can only sleep on my couches.
We brought our couch from home.
Oh, and your own paintings.
Cut to them going through airport security.
Yeah, so I know that the luggage might be a little bit oversized, but this is going to be my one carry-on.
And this will be my one carry-on as well. Very petite.
It's...
Right, well, see, the thing is, carry-ons have to be able to be carried. And seeing as you are wheeling those around in a wagon, I don't know if that's going to work out.
I can pick it up and carry it. Look,
she can pick it up. Come on.
It's really easy.
Look at that. That's an inch off the ground. She's got it.
I'm carrying it on.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I guess, but if the plane crashes, don't blame me.
Edit.
Okay, guys, so now that we've all, you know, we've kind of been initiated into this class dynamic, I figured that, you know, we're going to start off the school year right. I mean, you know, y'all are freshmen in college, and I'm your orientation advisor. And, you know, I think this just, like, this welcome to college hour that we're going to have every week, it's going to be so helpful for bonding with the team, you know?
It was an hour every week.
Yeah, every week. Yeah, Monday morning, 6 o'clock in the morning.
That's...
What if I have homework, though?
I don't care if you have homework. You're going to bond with your fellow students. Go Tigers!
If I miss a couple meetings, can I still enroll in my other classes, or, like...
If you miss any meetings, you won't be allowed into the residence hall until you attend another one. Your admittance into your residence hall is contingent on your attendance of the weekly meeting. Go Tigers!
Yeah, I'm just not sure how I feel about, you know, standing up at 6:05 precisely every day and reciting a loyalty oath.
Yeah, I have similar feelings about that loyalty oath.
Oh, come on! The loyalty oath to your good friends in Residence Hall 6B has to be taken every single week, or else we won't know how loyal you are to us.
You know, I also have some questions about the uniform. Like, is this long red robe, tiger-striped?
It's tiger-striped because we're the Tigers!
I actually kind of dig the uniform. Like, I would wear this all the time.
All right. Well, now that we've gotten that cleared up that you're going to be here every week no matter what, why don't we get started with our initiation ritual? Okay, I'm passing steak knives around to each and every one of you. Okay? Now, what I want you to do is take the steak knife. There should be a box next to you, right? In the box is a cat, okay? So you're going to take the cat and the steak knife.
It's a sixth grade. Yep, I know. It's pretty in the big leagues up here. You know, it's taken a while to get here.
I know. Jen, don't you feel like such a big kid?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm very excited, but we are going to get, all three of us, we are going to get number 1, 2, and 3 for the honors.
Who gets to have the number 1 spot?
I mean, as long as it's one of us. As long as it's one of us, I think it should be okay.
I want to be like in the middle of you guys.
Okay, so Jen will be number two. Carlos, why don't we rock, paper, scissors for the number one spot?
Okay, oh boy, here we go. Don't fail me now, rock, paper, scissors.
Not best out of three, just one, okay?
Just one?
Okay. On shoot, rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Okay, you ready?
Okay.
Rock
paper, scissors,
shoot.
No! Guess I'll get number three.
Champion, my friend.
You know, I didn't want it to come down to this, but you know, your yogurt has a funny taste in it, doesn't it, Jennifer?
Yeah, I was wondering what that was.
Don't worry, she'll only be knocked out for an hour. Sixth grader poison. I needed to secure my number one spot.
So you think knocking her out?
If she misses her test, then.
You guys are welcome for the poison from Katie.
Thank you, Katie.
Who is Katie?
You know, she's just been going around the school, helping everybody out.
Oh, it looks like she's waking up. I don't know how strong that poison was.
Where am I?
Wait.
Who are you?
She didn't miss it. Oh, uh-oh.
Who am I?
Do you not remember?
Where are we?
You're a person who likes to get 95s on tests.
That checks out. I love 95s.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
Yeah, I think hundreds are for suckers.
Edit.
There, out in the darkness, a fugitive running, fallen from God, fallen from grace. God be my witness, I never shall yield, till we come face to face, till we come face to face. He knows his way in the dark, mine is the way of the Lord. Those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if they fall as Lucifer fell, the flames, the sword. Stars in your multitudes, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with order and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. You know your place in the sky, you hold your course in your aim, and each in your season returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as Lucifer fell, you fall in flames. And so it must be, for so it is written on the doorway to paradise, that those who falter and those who fall must pay the price. Lord, let me find him, that I may see him, safe behind bars. I will never rest till then. This I swear, this I swear by the stars.
Let me explain something to you. Old Helen is gone, and you will not talk to me like that. Now I came here to help you. But now, I'm gonna get even. Shut up! You want Brenda and your kids? Do you see what you left me for? This is what you left me for. She didn't give a damn about you, Charles. She told them to let you die. I was your wife. I loved you. I would have never hurt you. Why did you do this to me? To us? Answer me! And you know what's funny? I gave you life. Even though you took it from me. And your kids, your boys. I wanted children, Charles! And had you not been with those whores, we would have them! Got me all stressed out, hair falling out, weight up and down, can't keep anything down. Two miscarriages! You took life from me! And you never even said, I'm sorry. I'm gonna let you sit here for a few days and think about what I just said.
Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. And scene. The clock struck 9 when I did send for the nurse. In half an hour she promised to return. Perchance she cannot meet him. That's not so. Oh, she is lame. Love's herald should be thoughts which 10 times faster glide than the sun's beams, driving back shadows over lowering hills. Therefore do nimble pinioned doves draw love, and therefore hath the wind-swift Cupid wings. Now is the sun upon the highmost hill of this day's journey. And from 9 to 12 is 3 long hours, yet she has not come. Had she affections and warm youthful blood, she would be as swift in motion as a ball. My words would bandy her to my sweet love and his to me. But old folks, many feign as they were dead, unwieldy, heavy, slow, and pale as lead. Oh God, she comes! Yeah, thanks.
Hear me now, thou bleak and unbearable world. Thou art base and debauched as can be. And the knight, with his banners all bravely unfurled, now hurls down his gauntlet to thee. I am I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha. My destiny calls and I go. And the wild winds of fortune will carry me onward, oh, whithersoever they blow. Whithersoever they blow. Onward to glory I go.
Well, Tommy's proposed to me again. Tommy really does nothing but propose to me. He proposed to me last night in the music room, when I was quite unprotected, as there was this elaborate trio going on. I didn't dare to make the smallest repartee. I need hardly tell you, because if I had, it would have stopped the music all at once. Music people are so absurdly unreasonable. They always want one to be perfectly dumb at the very moment when one is longing to be absolutely deaf. Then he proposed to me again in the broad daylight this morning in front of that dreadful statue of Achilles. Really, the things that go on in front of that work of art are quite appalling. The police should interfere. At luncheon, I saw by the glare in his eye that he was going to propose again, but I just managed to check him in time by assuring him that I was a bimetallist. Fortunately, I don't know what that means. I don't think anyone does. But the observation crushed Tommy. For about 10 minutes, he looked quite shocked. And then, Tommy is so annoying in the way he proposes. If he proposed at the top of his voice, then I should not mind so much. But he does so in this horrid confessional way. When Tommy wants to be romantic, he talks to me like a doctor. I am quite fond of Tommy, but his methods of proposing are so out of date. Would you speak to him, Gertrude? And tell him that once a week is quite often enough to propose to anyone, and that it should be done so in a manner that attracts some attention.
It's really meant to be.
My name is Samantha Mason, and this is my act entitled The Seven Deadly Sins. This is a dance project compilation, so it's seven different dances, each representing one of the seven deadly sins. I've been a dancer for as long as I can remember, so whenever I heard we were doing a performance project, I knew that I wanted to do a dance project. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
She keeps a Moët Chandon in a pretty cabinet. Decorate cake, she says, just like Marie Antoinette. A building, a remedy, the Prince job, and entity, and a town, an invitation you can't deny. Caviar, cigarettes, well versed in etiquette, extraordinarily nice. She's a killer queen.
on your shoulder, your love went down, your baby girl, the tears on your lip, they won't wait to you, and that's a deal, they call it show, they call it beautiful, the devil's cut, they make a woman, and tear will show, they put the bell, and that's a deal, they call it show. On n'avait rien oublié, c'est maman qui a tout fait. La mayonnaise, le chocolat, les champignons, les ombrecouettes et les tomates, les cornichons.
Whenever I see someone less fortunate than I, and let's face it, who isn't less fortunate than I, my tender heart tends to start to bleed. And when someone needs a makeover, I simply have to take over. I know exactly what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed. Follow my lead, and yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you the proper poise when you talk to boys, little ways to flirt and flounce. Ooh, I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix your hair, everything that really counts to be popular. I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts. You'll be good at sports.
Really? Well, I'll tell you what there is about me. There is an overwhelming, and there is an all-pervading hatred. A hatred for people like you. For people who lay even the littlest finger on children. I wake up with it. It wakes me up. It rides with me on the bus to work every morning. It whispers to me. It whispers to me, they will not get away with it. And I get here early, and I make sure all the bindings are clean and all the electrodes are in the right order so we won't waste time. And I'll admit it, sometimes I'll use excessive force, and sometimes I'll use excessive force on an entirely innocent individual. But let me tell you this, if an entirely innocent individual walks out of here into the outside world, they won't even think about raising their voice to another kid again, just in case I hear him and drag him in here for another load of excessive force. Now, is this kind of behavior in an officer of the law in any way morally reprehensible? Yeah? Yeah, well, I don't care. Because when I'm an old man, you know what? All the kids are gonna follow me around, and they're gonna know my name and what I stood for. And they're gonna give me their sweets and thanks. And I'll tell them to get home safely. And I'll be happy. Not because I like sweets. I don't really like sweets. But because I know in my heart that if I hadn't been there, not all of them would have been there. Because I'm a good policeman.
Take a drink. build the wall. My children, why do we build the wall?
Why do we build the wall? We build the wall to keep us free. That's why we build the wall. We build the wall to keep us free.
How does the wall keep us free? My children, how does the wall keep us free?
How does the wall keep us free? The wall keeps out the enemy. And we build the wall to keep us free. That's why we build the wall. We build the wall to keep us free.
Who do we call the enemy? Children, my children. Who do we call the enemy?
Who do we call the enemy? The enemy is poverty. And the wall keeps out the enemy. And we build the wall to keep us free. That's why we build the wall. We build the wall to keep us free.
Those we have and they have not. My children, because they want what we have got.
Because we have and they have not, because we want what we have got. The enemy is poverty, and the wall keeps out the enemy. And we build the wall to keep us free. That's why we build the wall. We build the wall to keep us free.
Should want. My children, what do we have that they should want?
What do we have that they should want? We have a wall to work upon. We have work and they have none.
And our world is never done. My children, and the war is never won.
The enemy is poverty, and the wall keeps out the enemy. And we build the wall to keep us free. That's why we build the wall. We build the wall to keep us free.
Bianca, and I'm going to be presenting my marketing campaign for Six the Musical. So this is my calendar for 8 weeks in advance, with show night, opening night, being on Friday, January 22nd, 2021. So the first thing on the calendar is every Friday for the first 6 weeks, each queen will have her own intro post going up on social media with information about the show, as well as information and like fun facts about her in the caption. The following Saturday from each of these posts will have a live stream Q&A with the cast member playing that queen. And the following Monday we'll have a merch drop for t-shirts, pins, and etc. products that have to do with that queen and her songs and lyrics in the show. Three separate Wednesdays we'll have cast meet and greet Zoom calls so that audience members can meet the cast. And on Saturday, January 16th, there will be a live stream with the entire cast on our Instagram as one last final thing before opening night. These are the first three social media posts that will be going out for the first three queens in the show, Catherine of Aragon, Anne Boleyn, and Jane Seymour, along with some information about the show and about them in their caption. And this is some of the different merch that is going to be going out. No Way for Catherine of Aragon, Sorry Not Sorry for Anne Boleyn, and Unbreakable for Jane Seymour, which are lyrics or song titles from their respective songs in the musical. And I wanted to use the fonts and colorings on this to show how their personalities differ. So No Way has a much more extravagant font with the gold colors, whereas Sorry Not Sorry and Unbreakable are both much more bold fonts, which fit the energy of their song a little bit better. And lastly, these are some pins that I designed. X-Wives 2021, X-Wives is the title song, a very first song in the musical. Welcome to the House of Holbein is one of the songs that is not specific to a queen, so didn't have a social media post correlated to it, so I made it into a pin. And I'm the Queen of the Castle is a song lyric featured in one of the songs from the Queens. So yeah, this is my presentation. Thank you so much, and I hope you enjoyed.
Hi everyone, my name is Lily Kearns, and I will be performing Maps from Fun Home. Quick dashes mark the property ends, Beach Creek, a rope that turns and bends, little squares for houses strung along roads, lands transfigured into topographic codes. Maps show you what is simple and true. Try laying out a bird's eye view. Not what he told you, just what you see. What do you know that's not your dad's mythology? You were born on this farm. Here's our house. Here's the spot where you died. I can draw a circle. Whole life lived inside. 4 miles from our door, I-80 ran from shore to shore on the way from the Castro to Christopher Street. The road less taken just 4 miles from our door. You were born on this farm. Here's our house. Here's the spot where you died. I can draw a circle. I can draw a circle. You lived your life inside. Thank you for watching.
I was thinking about what you said during our last session together, and I think you misunderstood what I was saying. I had wanted you to understand that what I was doing out there was charity, but it seems you were too ignorant to see that I was actually helping people. Well, so today I'm going to tell you the truth of all of it. I grew up with parents who did not consider me their own, and with brothers who enjoyed optimizing their power over me, who had no way to fight back. And these kids that I was working with all had similar experiences, so I understood where they came from, and I knew what they needed. And that's why I showed them how to fight. I gave them a way to redirect all the pain they had endured in their lives and finally feel free. I gave them security when no one else would by teaching them to protect themselves and be independent. I gave them a home, or at least finally a place they could consider home. And they knew that I cared for them. We were like a family, and they knew that I was only hard on them because, in a way, I guess, I loved them. I want you to understand that I wasn't hurting them. The injuries that I gave them were to make them stronger. I was being a hero. I am still a good person. And yes, I didn't want things to go as bad as they did, but you need to understand there were people who were threatening the entire system I had built. They knew that I had to keep our secret, that other people wouldn't be as easy to understand, and they would think that what I was doing was wrong, but they were selfish, and they were delusional, and they wanted to see that everything I had done destroyed. So I acted on behalf of everyone. When I got rid of our issue, their suffering was necessary. Saving everyone is more important than sparing a few misled rats. So now I'm here, sitting in front of you in chains. There is no question of my sanity, only in the people keeping me here. So do not mistake me again. I was helping those kids survive. For we live in a cruel world. I am a good person.
To dream the impossible dream. To fight the unbeatable foe. To bear with unbearable sorrow. To run where the brave dare not go. To right the unrightable wrong. To love pure and chaste from afar. To try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right, without question or pause. To be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I love.
My name is Orna Mukherjee, and I will be performing a song called A Change in Me. The name of my character is Belle from Beauty and the Beast. There's been a change in me, a kind of moving on. Though what I used to be, I still depend upon. it can come from bad. That may not make me wise, but oh, it makes me glad. And I never thought I'd leave behind my childhood dreams, but I don't mind.
It is down to you, and it is down to me. If you wish her dead, by all means, keep moving forward.
Let me explain.
There's nothing to explain. You're trying to kidnap what I have rightfully stolen.
Perhaps an arrangement can be reached?
There will be no arrangements. And you are killing her.
But if there can be no arrangements, then we are at an impasse.
It would appear so. I can't compete with you physically, and you are no match for my brains.
You're that smart.
Okay, let me put it this way. Have you ever heard of Plato, Aristotle, Socrates?
Yes.
Morons.
In that case, I challenge you to a battle of wits.
For the princess? To the death. I accept.
And pour the wine.
Inhale this, but do not touch.
I smell nothing.
What you do not smell is iocane powder. It is odorless, tasteless, dissolves instantly in water, and is one of the more deadly poisons known to man. Where is the poison? The battle of wits has begun. It ends when you decide, we drink, and we find who is right and who is wrong.
But it is so simple. All I have to do is divine it from what I know from you. Are you the sort of man who would put the poison into his own goblet or his enemies? Now, a clever man would put the poison into his own goblet, knowing that only a great fool would reach for what he was given. I am not a great fool, so clearly I cannot reach for the wine in front of you. But you must have known that I was not a great fool. You would have counted on it, so clearly I cannot reach for the wine in front of me.
You've made your decision, then.
Not remotely. Aiken comes from Australia, and as everyone knows, Australia is entirely peopled with criminals. Criminals who are not used to being trusted, as you are not trusted by me.
Truly, you have a dizzying intellect.
I'll wait till I get going. Where was I?
Australia.
Yes, Australia. And you must have suspected that I would know about the powder's origins. So clearly, I cannot choose a wine in front of me.
You're just stalling now.
Oh, you'd like to think that, wouldn't you? You've beaten my giant, which means that you're exceptionally strong. So you could have put the poison into your own goblet, trusting on your own strength to save you. So clearly, I cannot choose the wine in front of you. But you have also bested my Spaniard, which means that you must have studied. And in studying, you would have learned that man is mortal. So clearly, I cannot choose the wine in front of me.
You're trying to trick me into revealing something. It won't work.
It already has worked. You've given away everything. Good. I know where the poison is.
Then make your choice.
I will, and I choose. What in the world could that be?
What?
Where?
I don't see anything.
I could have sworn I saw something. No matter.
What's so funny?
I'll tell you in a minute. First, let's drink. Me from my glass and you from yours.
You chose wrong.
You only think I chose wrong. That's what's so funny. I switched the glasses when your back was turned. Hi, you fool. You fell victim to one of the classic blunders. The most famous being, never get involved in a land war in Asia. And the second, only slightly less well known, never bet against a Sicilian when death is on the line.
Who are you? I'm no one to be trifled with. That's all you'll ever need to know.
And to think, the poison was in your cup all along.
They were both poisoned. For the past few years, I've been developing an immunity to Iocane powder. When you decide, we drink, and we find who is right and who is dead.
All right, hold on. Do that one line over again, because I can edit out that mess up.
Okay. The Battle of Wits begins. It ends when you decide, we drink. What?
Begins? All right, one more time. Here we go.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
The Battle of Wits is begun. It ends when you...
Come on, y'all.
Was I? Australia.
Yes, Australia. Okay.
You're right.
Yes, Australia. And you must have suspected that I don't know about the powder's origin. So clearly, I cannot choose the wine in front of me.
You'd like to think that...
You're just stalling.
Okay. You're just stalling.
You would like to think that, wouldn't you? You've beaten my giant.
Okay, so go back to, you're just stalling.
Yeah. Back to Australia, right?
Australia. And as everyone knows, wait, that wasn't the line.
Australia.
Okay. All right, hold on, new take.
It is down to you, and it is down to me.
I'm sorry, that's my fault.
Inhale this, but do not smell.
Okay.
Then pour the wine. Hold on. You never did it like that.
So
Christmas, there won't be boys playing with bombs like kids play with toys. One warm December, our hearts will see a world where men are free. Someday at Christmas, there'll be no wars, where we have learned what Christmas is for, what we have found, what life really worth. There will be peace on earth. Someday all our dreams will come to be. Someday in a world where men are free. Maybe not in time for you and me, but someday at Christmas time. Someday at Christmas we'll see a land with no hungry children, no empty hand. One happy morning people will share a world where people care. Someday at Christmas, there'll be no tears.
Diamonds are forever. They are all I need to please me. They can stimulate and tease me. They won't leave in the night. I've no fear that they might desert me. Diamonds are forever. Hold one up and then caress it. Touch it, stroke it, and undress it. I can see every part. Nothing hides in their heart to hurt me. Diamonds are forever. Pussycat, men grow cold as girls grow old, and we all lose our charms in the end. But square cut or pear shaped, these rocks don't lose their shapes. Diamonds are the girl's best friend.
Well, I'm 14. My guidance counselor had taken some interest in me. Who knows what she saw in me wearing Barry's hand-me-down rugby shirts. But she entered me in a local beauty pageant. She got me a nice dress, makeup, everything really. Yep, she got me all dolled up. It's a silly story. But, the pageant came, and, well, she tried to get my father to go, but, you know, he wouldn't. And then I won. I won. And, well, they gave me this tiara, and I just remember being so proud. I walked home, and, you know, there was my father sitting on his lazy boy, watching something on TV, having a grand old time. Well, I patiently waited until the next commercial. And then I gave him this tap on the shoulder, not wanting to bother him. And I walked up in front of him and I showed him this tiara, my crown. And I'll never forget what happened next. He looked at me and smiled and said, "Are you my little Miss Universe? Are you my Miss America?" And in that moment, I finally had it. I had gotten his attention. And well, this is gonna sound really weird, but up until that moment, I'd never realized how blue my father's eyes were.
I have dreamed thee too long, never seen thee or touched thee, but known thee with all of my heart. Half a prayer, half a song, thou hast always been with me, though we have been always apart. Dulcinea, Dulcinea, I see heaven when I see thee, Dulcinea, and thy name is like a prayer. An angel
whisper. I think we could do it if we tried.
Hi, I'm Lucy, and here's my project. It's a little song I wrote after, reading a lot of books during quarantine and watching a little bit too much TikTok about said books. And so, I don't know, I've been feeling really inspired recently, and so I threw together this little song, and I really hope you guys like it. This song is dedicated to my right leg. Thanks for always being there to stand up for me.
I'm in love with a fictional boy. Can't escape reality. I'm in love with your fictional voice. Oh, planting seeds I'll never get to see. Take me to your garden, I would take you by the hand. Teach me all the things that I could never understand. I'd be tugging on your heartstrings, you'd be playing with my hair. Never had the heart to tell you I was never really there. Days blur together, the nights aren't much better. You whisper to me that you're here. I'm sorry, I don't know the things that I should, though you ask me to hold myself dear. If you'd kept me around, yeah, I think you'd have found something there. Oh, the days blur together, the nights are much better. You whisper to me that you're here. I'm sorry, I don't know the things that I should, though
something?
Sure. Where do you want to go?
I don't know. Why don't we, like, meet by the park at your house or something? What happens?
Alright. That sounds good. What time are you thinking?
Let's say, like, 10. I just got home from work and I do not want to get up early.
Sucks. Okay, sounds good. I'll see you then.
Well, I have you. How was your week?
Good. I went to my friend's birthday party.
Oh, cool. Who?
You don't know her. I think you went to preschool with her.
That was fun. What'd y'all do?
We went to see that new movie, the Black Widow one, and then we went out to dinner and I had a sleepover in this really cool hotel room.
That was super cool. Damn, I just worked 2 double shifts all weekend, every day, and then we went to my grandparents' house for a few days, which is nice.
Okay, that still sounds fun. What'd you do there?
We had a lot of good time, a lot of fun, nice to see family. I went to my grandfather's favorite band, the Rolling Stones, because they were in concert, and it was really, like, loud and crowded, and there were a lot of people, and I really didn't know all the words or, like, any of them, but it was really fun.
Make 3 songs.
I absolutely cannot.
You're a fake fan.
I never said I was.
Whatever.
Hey, okay, so how would you feel about hanging out with our old lunch group this weekend? Like, Sunday-ish, the plan is to go to Six Flags and just, like, have a good time.
Oh, I love Six Flags. Who's going?
You expect me to remember that? I think it's, like, 12 people? That sounds right.
You should probably remember the names of our friends.
I know their names, I just don't remember which ones are going. I know exactly 3 things, and that is not one of them.
That is embarrassing, but you did go to South By, and I'll be eternally jealous of you, so you got me.
So what are your, like, summer plans in general? Just curious.
Oh, I'm actually really excited. I'm going to Portugal on an exchange program, and yeah, I have a few concerts lined up. But mostly I'm just going to hang out with friends. Maybe I'll go to Porto for a weekend with my family. What about you? That sounds very fun. I'm just planning on working a bunch, staying up late, hanging out with all sorts of friends and all sorts of people, annoying my coworkers. I have a sleepaway camp. I have a sleepaway camp all of June, though, which I'm really looking forward to, because I get to spend, like, three-ish, four-ish weeks there and just see all these people that I never get to see. And then I'm going to North Carolina to hang out with my great aunt and uncle and all my little cousins, and I absolutely hate airports, but it's worth it to see them.
Well, you don't really have much of a choice if you go or not.
I enjoy the illusion of choice. Please indulge me.
Of course you do. Well, if you're not doing anything at any point, just hit me up.
Alright, we'll do, loser. Let's have the best time of our lives.
Parties and people, here we come.
Hey. Hello?
Hey, Zoe.
What's up?
Not much.
Hey, you want to hang out? Oh, sorry. My parents want me to be, like, extra careful right now. So no, cases are on the rise and it's just not looking good. But I'll see you on Zoom tomorrow.